top of the gravel to set the boiler on. We'll show you what that looks like when we get done.
Hello. Today I'd like to talk to you about my Woodmaster 5500 boiler that I just recently installed. It has roughly a 200 gallon water jacket surrounding the burn chamber. It's rated for about 300,000 BTUs. I'll show you the chamber here. It's going right now. It's been going for about a week and a half. It's hard to see in there right now, but it's pretty good sized. You could fit 5 small children in there. On the side of the boiler, you have the electronic control system. Basically, it has a light, and then the thermometer, and then what happens when the water temperature falls below 160 degrees, it turns the fans on. There's 2 fans, one on the back of the boiler and one in the door. It forces air in, then it heats up the water until the temperature gets back up to 170 degrees, and then it shuts off. On the back of the boiler, underneath that panel, there's 2 circulating pumps. One is pumping hot water through 1-inch insulated PEX piping from the boiler to my garage, and then the other one is pumping it to my house. The house run was about 50 feet and the garage run was about 30 feet. When you come in my house, this is where my boiler pipe enters. It was buried outside in the ground approximately 18 inches. It comes in and follows a path over to my hot water heater. So what the water does is it runs through this thing here called a heat exchanger, and the boiler water runs through there, and then also incoming water to the hot water heater runs through there, and the 2 waters are always separated, but the heat is transferred from the boiler water to the water going to the hot water heater. And then also underneath all this insulation, I have another 2 heat exchanger that keeps the water in the hot water heater hot all the time. And then once it leaves the hot water heater, the boiler water goes over to another heat exchanger. This is just like the one on the wall over there, only this one is 5 times bigger, and it's under the insulation there. But the purpose of this one is to heat the water in my existing LP boiler system. My LP boiler right now is shut off, but if I needed to use it, I could light the pilot and turn it on. But with that heat exchanger, I'm keeping the boiler at a consistent 160 degree temperature all the time. And then what happens when the thermometer upstairs calls for heat, it opens one of these valves. One goes to the upper level and the other valve goes to our main level. It opens a valve and turns on the circulator pump here that pumps the hot water through our baseboard radiant heat system on the main levels. And then when the demand for heat is satisfied, the valves close, the pump turns off. This pump over here, that continuously is on. It's always circulating water through a loop that goes through my LP boiler through the heat exchanger, so that the LP boiler water is always hot and the LP boiler never feels a need to kick on. Once the hot water leaves my LP boiler, it comes up onto my porch and goes through this radiator looking thing. This radiator looking thing is a heater. It's got a fan on the back and it's controlled by a switch that I have installed on the wall over here. So if I want heat out here, I just throw on the switch, which I just did, and it will start the fan on the back of there, and it will put out quite a bit of heat. It's a 55,000 BTU heater. And then in the house, this is our baseboard radiators. These are going along pretty much all the interior walls. That's where the water is pumped through the existing system, and we get radiant heat from that. Outdoor wood boilers, you can also use them in forced air systems. They basically, instead of pumping water through a radiator or a wall unit like this, the water is pumped through a radiator connected to your furnace, and the fan blows air through your furnace and through your ducting system. Now we're in my garage. I have the boiler hooked up to one of those larger heaters that I have insulated and protected right now because I'm not using it, but that's a much larger one than I have on my porch. And then after the water goes through there, it comes to this, which is heating my hot tub right now. There's a thermostat there that turns on a valve that when the hot tub falls below a certain temperature, the valve opens, and there's a heat exchanger in the hot tub unit that will draw heat from the boiler water and keep the hot tub warm. I'm hoping this will save $50 a month in electricity, but I just installed it the other day, so we'll find out. This is what the insulated 1-inch PEX looks like. This is what they called a 3-wrap. You can get it a lot more insulated, but my runs weren't very long, so I chose for a little bit less insulation to save some money. So far, for my purposes, I think it's working. But it hasn't been very cold out yet this year, so when it gets really cold, we'll find out how much heat I'm losing through the PEX. And the last part of this video, this is just where I've got the PEX coming from my garage through that piping into my hot tub. I unplugged the heater, the electric heater from my hot tub 2 days ago, and it's been running off of the boiler, and it's 102 degrees.